Straight up, general dollars, general support dollars, experimentation dollars, seed dollars, innovation dollars, not worrying about being able to pay your folks family sustaining, fair, equal wage, and making sure that you can carry out the work. If folks want to be a part of our movement, if they can't meet their basic needs, then how are we supposed to win at social justice and social justice movement?
Look at what are the needs of the people who are actually doing the work. And leading the work and how they can be personally supported is really important, because there's just still this thought process that if you are in movement work, you are doing it out of the love and you don't need any money to do it.
The most important thing for me has been time to conspire, to strategize, to think with people outside of like this everyday bubble that care about the issue, that have their own level of expertise, that know the players in a different way, to help me think about how we move forward.
We think about a career is 40 to 50 years long. In this work, a 5 to 10 year span of time can be a 40 to 50 year burden on a person's body, mind, and soul. And so how are we thinking about allowing people to breathe and building that in?
What ends up happening is that, at least for me as a leader, I end up spending so much more time on the administrative side, filling out the applications, writing the reports, finding the accountants, like, and all the things that I hate. What I love to do and what I'm actually really good at with the strategy, the visioning, the organizing, I'm doing less and less of that. More and more I'm being taken away from the actual mission of doing on the ground work.
We also need like grants that go into the infrastructure development, really. I think we need more funders who are willing to give you grants to be like, you know what, it's okay if you don't do programming this year. But if you are gonna take a year and pause and you're gonna build out your structure of the organization, that would be such a weight off, because I think sometimes we worry that if we don't produce the programmatic work, you know, we reached X people, we built out 10 leaders, we did this, then like the grantor is like, well, what did you actually do?
No, like after year one, so where's this coalition that you've talked about? Where's this platform that you are hoping to do? Like, okay, like you all will get there at the speed that you will get there. Just trust in leadership without strings attached. That is what is ultimately needed if we really want to see the type of change that our communities deserve.
Philanthropy needs to be aware of an ecosystem, and I think this is true in every community. It's a way of strengthening the collective leadership, and that's what movements produce. Thank you.